patience of thy stay. From Samos have I winged my way to meet thy slow return. With all his speed, not yet the sun through half his race has run, since I to execute thy dread command have thrice encompassed this land. Say, where is Semele's abode? Look with his sea proudly stands. Vision, parting from the Christian land, high on the summit of that hill, beyond the reach of mortal eyes, by Jove's command and Vulcan skill, behold a new erected palace wise.
Sway, I swear
each of crooks they lust them for his kings. And Conductor, Graeme, and Wallace, and as a skinny horse's boy, he all at once did float.
So Jupiter's wife Juno steams off to browbeat the dozy god Somnus into backing her scheme, that is, to break up Jupiter's cozy menage with the mortal Semele, at the end of the first scene of Act 2 of Handel's opera, coming to you live from the London Coliseum. As the set's being changed, we've time to pick up the story. Act 2, Scene 2 finds Semele where else but in bed. Unlike Somnus, sleep isn't exactly what she's longing for. Jupiter's obviously besotted with her. But there's a cloud on the horizon. Not surprisingly, Semele rather fancies herself as a goddess, which gets Jupiter in something of a tiz. Has he bitten off more than he can chew with this pretty young mortal and her delusions of grandeur? To take Semele's mind off things, he conjures up a vision of Arcadia and magics her sister Ino up from Earth to keep her company. Act 2, Scene 2, of Handel Semele.
Thank you. I were. Think not I man's cause would bear. Think not I man's cause would bear. For this human form I were. And for joys, and for joys, and for joys alone provide. And for and require time to rest and to repose. I was not absent. While love was with thee, I was present. Love and I are one.
Oh,
gentle sorrow swells thy soft bosom. Why tremble those fair eyes with interrupted light, where hovering for a vent amidst the humid fire some new-formed wish appears? Speak and obtain.
What unhappiness I sigh and tremble, for I am mortal, still a woman. And ever when you leave me, oh, come to throng with daisies of love and graces. A fear invades me, and conscious of an age of war inferior, I seek for solitude and a shun society.
Too well I read her meaning, but must not understand her. Aiming at immortality with dangerous ambition. I must with speed amuse her, lest she too much explain, lest she too much explain. I must with speed amuse her, lest she too much explain. I must with speed amuse her, lest she too much explain. I must with speed amuse her, lest she too much explain. I must with speed amuse her, lest she too much explain. I must with speed amuse her, lest she too much explain. Lest she too much explain. Lest she too much explain. And healing must refuse. It is a love, a double pain. Quizzes nim complain, and healing must refuse her. And healing must
Thank you.
by my command, now at this instant, two winged zephyrs from her downy bed, my much-loved Ino bear, and both together waft her hither through the balmy air.
Shall I, my sister, say the dear companion of my tender years?
When she appears, she'll see not me, for I am visible alone to thee. While I retire, rise and meet her, and with welcomes greet her. Now all this scene shall to Arcadia turn, the seat of happy nymphs and swains. There, without the rage of jealousy, they burn and taste the sweets of love without its pain. Thank you.
states and peopled towns we pass, o'er hills and valleys, and o'er deserts waste, o'er barren moors, and o'er unwholesome fens and woods, where beasts inhabit dreadful dens. All which passes away, our speed was such, we stop not once the pace of earth to touch. Meantime, they told me, while through air we fled, that Jove did not ordain.
So Jupiter has quite literally given Semele the earth, but will he promise her the immortal heavens? That's the end of Act 2 of Handel's opera Semele, and we'll have to wait until after the interval to discover Semele's fate. Juno is sung by Susan Bickley, Iris by Janis Kelly, Rosemary Joshua takes the title role, her lover Jupiter is John Mark Ainsley, and her sister Ino, Sarah Connolly.